Hey guys, it's Carrie here, and I'm back to talk about motivation and to talk about limiting beliefs and go into a little bit more detail than I did in my last video. Before I get started, I wanted to say I got my hair cut. I don't know if I had showed you guys or not. It looks a little more styled today, so I don't mind having it down. But yeah, it was just time for a change. I really felt like I needed to just like get rid of some old energy. And I love it. I think it's really the best haircut I've ever had. Probably suits me the best, at least for this time in my life. And so, yeah, just kind of a little aside, if any of you are considering like changing your appearance, or you just kind of feel like, you know, the person I was a few months ago, I feel like I'm evolving so quickly that I would like to do something to kind of, you know, just show this new side of me or whatever. So I feel like I'm really coming into my power. I feel like I want to really like work hard on some things. So I don't want to be spending as much time like having to upkeep hair or things like that. So it's just a really simple little thing like that could be life-changing, you know? What are the things that are maybe like preventing you from doing certain things? Like if you think about all your chores or all your responsibilities, are there some things that you could either eliminate completely, or are there some things that you could pay other people to do for you so that you don't have to do them, and then also help them out? Maybe they need the money. So how can you just kind of like simplify and streamline your life at this time? So with that being said, guys, my name is Carrie. This channel is called Sovereign Creator Coaching. Here we discuss coming into your best self, your highest self, your sovereign self. We discuss manifesting, although not in your, you know, really not in your popular terms, because with manifesting, we see that on this channel as just a natural state, okay? It's nothing, in other words, it's nothing special. It's only seen as special in this time that we're in because people have forgotten their true self. But once you remember the true self, you remember that manifesting is just as normal as, you know, breathing. It's just part of your nature. So with that being said, guys, if you haven't watched the video I made right before this, go back and do me a favor. Go back and watch that. It's pretty short because we're discussing your limiting beliefs and how your limiting beliefs or your subconscious blockages hold you back from doing some of those things that you really want to do and that you really want to accomplish. Okay, now, I had a comment on the last video. You guys can go ahead and read that. A gentleman said that, you know, he doesn't agree with this idea of motivation because it's as simple as if you're interested in something, then you'll do it. If you're not interested, you won't do it. Therefore, there's no need for motivation. Okay. I see it slightly differently. There are things in our life that we are interested in, that we want to do. Okay. For instance, I'm interested in losing weight. I've been interested in losing weight for years now. Okay. Not because I feel like I look terrible or not because I'm not in good health, simply because I personally have a desire to look a certain way and to physically feel lighter. Okay. However, over the last couple of years, my weight has only increased, all right? And so that's the exact opposite of what I'm interested in, what I'm interested in having. So what do I need to get me there? What is going to help me get past this? What is going to help me lose the weight that I want to lose? Motivation. I'm gonna need some motivation, right? I'm gonna need to take some action. But like in the past, it's been hard for me to do some of those things, those actions that I need to take, because there's a lack of motivation. Okay. And the lack of motivation in this particular instance is because of times where I've tried and I've failed to lose it, or times where I, you know, lost weight, but then 6 months later, a year later, I gained it back and maybe a little bit more. And those experiences are in my subconscious mind to where I'm equivalating this current, you know, time, this current effort with failing, right? And every single person, including the gentleman who left that comment on the last video, I think everybody has been interested in a goal or something they want to achieve, and then found that they're lacking the motivation to take action because they have blockages, because they have self-limiting beliefs that are stopping them. Okay, so this series, I'm going to make it a series, is going to be about going deeper into that. Okay, how do you become aware of what those are? How do you work on eliminating them? How do you work on getting past the blockages, past the obstacles to your goal? Okay, to whatever you're trying to manifest, to whatever you're trying to create. As a sovereign creator, we're obsessed with this. We're obsessed with creating. We're obsessed with taking control over your life. We're obsessed with being in control of your physical experience, because now is the time for that. Now is the time that you came for to be that. You've waited a long time to be in the time that we're in now, in this amazing portal or space that we've all collectively created in order for us as individuals to really experience being that sovereign creator while at the same time being a physical human, and to be able to play with those two worlds and merge that experience into this beautiful, exhilarating life experience that we all want to have. There's nobody that doesn't want to have an amazing life, okay? I mean, can you imagine someone being like, you know what? I would like a really like bad life. I want like a really hard, terrible life. Nobody. We all have that in common. It does not matter what our skin color is, what our sex, meaning our gender is, where we were born, what our childhood was like. It is a universal desire to have a great life. Why? Because that is the nature of the universe, and we are part of the universe. We are an inseparable part of the universe. So that you can look at yourself and see, what is the true nature of God? What is the true nature of the universe? Well, what are my inherent desires? My inherent deep rooted desire is to have joy, to have a good life, and to be abundant. Well, then that is the true nature of the universe. And your desire to have that is you trying to align yourself with your true nature. Okay, so we're coming into a time on this earth where that's going to be completely possible, and where you've got to start really thinking bigger and letting the lid off of this and letting that just, because I promise you, there is literally nothing that you want, that you desire, that you really feel strongly inside about, that you cannot have and that you cannot achieve. And if you're still feeling a resistance to hearing that, to me saying that to you, if you're still feeling like, okay, this, you know, this woman is like too much, this is too much, this is making me uncomfortable, okay, that's a blockage, that's a self-limiting belief. Okay, so if this is too uncomfortable for you, this is where the channel is headed. We're headed into complete authenticity. We're headed into saying uncomfortable things. We're headed into more of getting the truth out there unwatered down, and then taking actual physical hard, sometimes hard steps in order to get this going and be our best selves. Okay, so I would love to hear from you guys. There was 20 some people that watched the last video. It's been up, I don't know, maybe a day, but I didn't get any other comments other than that one. And the question that I had for you guys was, do you actually feel yourself lacking motivation with something in your life that you're trying to accomplish, and it's frustrating to you because you want to do it, but you can't seem to take action? Okay, that's what I had asked you guys. Why are you watching the channel if you don't want to participate? And I don't mean that in a bad way, guys. It's all out of love. I don't mean you have to write, you know, comments if you don't want to. You don't have to do anything you don't want to do. But at least participate, like, in your own world, okay? At least give yourself that opportunity to answer this for yourself. You don't have to answer it for me. So think about that. What was it? What was it that you're really trying to do that you are lacking the motivation to do? And if you want to share it, if you don't mind sharing it for the benefit of everybody, put it in the comments, guys. And if you are getting something out of this video and out of my videos and off of my energy, please like the video. Please subscribe if you haven't subscribed. And if you want to know exactly when a new video of mine's coming out, then you have to go up and hit the bell and you get notifications on your phone. Okay. Some people don't like that. I know for the channels that I'm actually getting something out of that I actually enjoy and appreciate, I have notifications on because I get excited when I see the banner on my phone and that they have a new video. And I'm sure some of you do too. So it's the same with this channel, guys. Same thing, like, subscribe, share if you think somebody could use this information. But above all, be good to yourself, be patient with yourself, and commit to yourself. Commit to yourself that you are not going to settle. You are not going to just live a status quo life. You're going to be the sovereign creator that you came here to be, and you're going to get everything that you want. And you make that level of commitment to yourself, and then you will find the teachers, the resources, the guidance, the coaching, the friends. You will find every single thing start to come in to prove to you that the universe takes your commitments seriously. It takes your decisions seriously. All right, guys, thank you so much. I hope you have a wonderful weekend, and I will be back as soon as the universe tells me to be back, and I think it's going to be soon.